10th plus 2 level over andum thodarndhu maanila alavil pala saadhanaigalai purindhu varum Namakkal Kurinji Kalvi Nirvanangalil CBSE paadathittathil senior secondary palliyaga tharam uyarthappattu IIT NEET thervugalukku pala vetriyaalargalai uruvaakkiya aasiriyargalai mulu nera aasiriyargalaga paniyamarthappattu thinamdorum vaguppugal nadaiperum
Kurinji Educational Institution Kaavettipatti Namakkal Admission in progress CBSE KG to 12th contact 9025895176 Metric 6 to 12th contact 9344567484 For online admission log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in
Dear students, warm welcome to 11th standard English class. Now I would like to teach poem of 11th standard Once Upon a Time written by Gabriel Okara. He is a Nigerian poet and novelist. He has written more works. His works translated into many languages. This is the poem of Gabriel Okara. He through this poem he advises his son. Once Upon a Time. It was written by Gabriel Okara. He was born in 1921. He is a novelist, Nigerian novelist and poet. His verse has been translated into several languages. His poem, "The Call of the River Nun," won the best award for literature at the Nigerian Festival of Arts in 1953. Some of his poems were published in the influential periodical Black Orpheus, and by 1960 he established himself as an accomplished writer. He was honored with the Commonwealth Poetry Award. Okara's typical poem transits from everyday reality to moments of delight and moves back to reality, making a complete circle. Okara infused African thought, folklore and imagery to both his verse and prose. His first novel, The Voice, is an outstanding linguistic experiment. His later works include a collection of poems. The Fisherman's Invocation was written on 1878, and the two books for children, Little Snake and Little Frog, 1981, and An Adventure to Juju Island, 1992. Okay, this is the poem of Gabriel Okara's Once Upon a Time. This is the poem advice to his son. Okay, see, the poet Okara in his narrative monologue painfully condemns the falsity displayed by adults both in their words and actions. Here a father laments to his son about the negative changes that creep into the attitude and behavior of humans. When they grow into adults, he says that people used to be genuine when they laugh, and the honesty would be reflected in their eyes. Now I say the summary of this poem before teach the poem. But people of modern times laugh superficially. Their handshakes used to be warm and happy, conveying a sense of togetherness, but nowadays the handshakes have become a mere duplicity. He warns his son that people are not trustworthy and have become so selfish that they are concerned only about their own personal benefits. See, people utter words of welcome and exchange pleasantries, but those words come only from the tip of their tongues, but not from the depth of their hearts. Humans have learned the art of changing their facial expressions according to situations merely to ensure social acceptance. They wear masks and exhibit multiple faces. The narrator admits that he has also changed into a hypocrite. Hypocrite, you know, this is a character to acting to another person's, not from inner mind, inner heart. Okay. However, he tells his son that though he fakes his expressions, all the expressions of nowadays persons are probably fake, he does all this against his will. He says he wants to become a child again. he does not like to behave with the other adults and laugh genuinely. He wants to unlearn the unreal things and mirror how to laugh as he had done once upon a time. When he laughs before the fangs, he sees no expression. His teeth are bare like that of the fangs of a snake. So he asks his son to show him how to laugh the way he used to laugh when he was a kid like him. See the poetical lines of this poem. Once upon a time, son, they used to laugh with their hearts and laugh with their eyes, but now they only laugh with their teeth, while their eyes block, cold eyes search behind the shadow. See the first line of this stanza. First stanza, every stanza contains six lines. Once upon a time, this is a repetition word. We can see through this poem more time. Once upon a time, son, they used to laugh with their hearts. He advises his son, once upon a time, when he was in his childhood, the persons he met in his childhood, they used to laugh with their hearts. Not they are laughing from their inner mind and heart. But nowadays, the contemporary society persons is not like that. They are laughing now only as a hypocrite then, and laugh with their eyes. In those days, they laugh their eyes. We can see the laugh from their eyes. The eyes also very pleasant and glad with the other persons when they were talking or behaving then. But now they only laugh with their teeth. Nowadays, they are laughing with their teeth only. See, while their eyes black, cold eyes. See the line. While their eyes black, cold eyes search behind my shadow. Here it means, see the line, while their eyes black, cold eyes. This line is considered as metaphor. Search behind my shadow. Nowadays, the persons are laughing only through teeth, not from inner mind or heart. We can see the entire stanza of this first. We can see in a nutshell. See, the poet tells his son that in the olden days, people used to laugh with their hearts. When they laugh, they would do it wholeheartedly and with warmth. They used to laugh with their emotions. They would laugh with their eyes and show pleasure with them. See, in this first stanza, we can see two poetic devices. First line, once upon a time, this is a repetition of words. Then, while their eyes black, cold eyes, it is a metaphor. Then, see, the second stanza of this poem, there was a time indeed, they used to shake hands with their hearts, but that's gone, son. Now shake hands without hearts, while their left hand search my empty packets. Through this stanza, he tells his son, there was a time indeed, in those days, they used to shake hands with their hearts. In those days, persons who behaving with others, hands shaking is they gave, and shaking hands through their inner hearts. But that's gone, son. Nowadays, not like that, son. Now they shake hands in the contemporary society without hearts. Without hearts mean without any thinking. They are expecting something from others only. This is the concept of this second stanza. While their left hand search my empty packets. When they were shaking hands with me, they are searching or they are expecting what I have, what they can get from me. This is the concept of the second stanza. We can see in a nutshell. But now they laugh without any emotions. It is a fake laugh. They watch you with their eyes, which lack a feeling of warmth or endearing expression. It indicates lack of emotions or feelings in their look. The people are hypocritical nowadays, and they don't mean what they say. We can see the poem entirely tells to his son through this poet the advice only. Okay, see, when he was in childhood, the poet Gabriel Okara was innocent, honest, and sincere. But when he grew to be an adult, the society has changed him. He has learned how to love without any warm feelings. He learned to shake hands with others without wholeheartedness. He also has learned to act or behave to the need of the situation. For that, he has to wear a standard deceitful artificial smile on all occasions. It looks like a smile in a fixed picture or a painting. He has learned to say goodbye, wherein he actually has to say good riddance. A feeling of relief when an unwanted person leaves, he has even learned to say glad to meet you without being glad. This is also a type of hypocrisy. He says the hypocrisy word in this poem through these sentences. He also has learned to say, "It has been nice talking to you," after being bored with his talks. So he has learned to keep his real character a secret and shows the world a fake character. See the third stanza. Feel at home. Come again. They say, feel at home. Come again. They say, and when I come. See the last two lines of the second stanza. While their left hand search my empty baggage. He says, if a person laughs at him, he wanted to expect from him something. See, feel at home, come again. This is the line, sarcasm. Sarcasm is a type of irony. Feel at home, come again. People says, feel at home, my house, like you, come again. They can say, but this is also a hypocrisy. That's why he says through this line, sarcasm. It's a type of irony. They say, and when I come again and feel at home, once, twice, there will be no thrice. For then I find doors shut on me. Here he says, feel at home, come again. A person who relatives or friends may tell you, feel at home, my house, come again. They can say, but they say, and when I come regularly or once or twice again and feel, they would feel at home once, twice. There will be no thrice. If a person goes to the home more times, they feel not happy. For then I find doors shut on me. Often if they come to their home, in front of him, they shut the door. See, through this third stanza, he says, feel at home. He tells that people will repeatedly invite you to come again to their home, and they say that you can feel as if you are at your home, but in real sense, they expect you to accept their invitations. You can go there once or twice, but if you go for a third time, they will not let you in. You will find that their doors are closed. They will think that you are a nuisance and don't want to see you anymore. Particularly if you are a frequent visitor, the doors will be closed ever in front of you. Belatedly, you will understand that their invitations are without any sincerity. Their invitations are always not in sincerity. If you go to thrice or above than thrice, you will be not given any respect or something. Okay, through the third stanza we can see like that. Then the poet further tells about the characteristics of the people of the past. When you meet them, they will shake hands with pleasure and with warmth and do it willingly and wholeheartedly. He tells his son that those habits have gone, unfortunately. Nowadays, people greet each other without any warmth in their handshake. It is just like a routine formality. When they shake with their right hands with him, their left hands will search his empty pockets. This we can see through the second sense of the meaning. Will search his empty pockets. That is, they are evaluating the people's worth and power of calculating how he could be exploited. If it shows that the people's friendship and intimacy is all for selfish motives only. See, in this poem, the poet quite criticizes the entirely, he criticizes the modern people, the modern lifestyle of people, while comparing them with that of the people of olden days, olden times. In the past, people were honest in their behavior in those days. When they laugh, they will do it wholeheartedly with a warm feeling. When you meet them, they will shake hands with pleasure. But nowadays, people are hypocritical and their laugh is fake one. There will not be any warmth in their handshakes. See, the poet tells to his son, people will repeatedly invite you to come again to their home and say that you can feel at if you are at your home, but in real sense, they don't expect you to accept their invitations. You can go there once or twice, but if you go for the third time, they will not let you in. You will find that their doors are closed ever. They will think that you are a nuisance and don't want to see you any more. So I have learned many things, son. I have learned to wear many faces, like dresses, home face, office face, street face, host face, cocktail face, with all their conforming smiles, like a fixed portrait smile. See, through this fourth stanza, the poet says, so I have learned many things through this world up to now. From my childhood, son, I have learned still now to wear many faces. The people nowadays shows many faces. Their all of their face and expressions are look like mostly they are very, very commercial only. I have learned to wear many faces, like dresses. Here, like dresses, here comes in the third line, like dresses. That's why it's considered as simile. Like dresses, home face, office face, street face, host face, cocktail face, with all their conforming smiles, like a fixed portrait smile. Here also in the last line, simile comes because likes has come. See, like dresses, home face. Many people we can see in the streets or neighboring places, home face. Some people show their face in their home, like a face, and office, they will show another one, street face, their expressions. Expressions are told by the poet, like dresses, home face, office face, street face, host face, cocktail face mean mixed emotion. Here cocktail face mean face showing mixed emotions and with all their conforming smiles. Here conforming smiles, here it means conforming smiles like a fixed portrait smile. Here these lines with all their conforming smiles like a fixed portrait smile. Here it means wearing a standard deceitful artificial smile. All the smiles of nowadays, the contemporary society people shows the artificial smile on all occasions. They are not laughing through their inner mind or heart. He says, that through this entire stanza, the poet further says to his son that he has learned many things. He has learned to act or behave to the need of the situation. According to the situation, they change their face and expressions. The changing of masks is like changing of dresses. They are changing their expressions according to the situations like dresses. In home, he will have one face. In the office, he acts in one way to a person with a different face. When he meets someone or stranger on the street, he acts another way. When he acts with mixed emotions in his office or home, he has to put on a cocktail mask. Cocktail means mixed emotions in a face. So he has to wear a standard deceitful. Deceitful means cheating, artificial smile on all occasions. It looks like a smile in a fixed picture or a painting. See, in this stanza we can see two similes. Okay, see, the poem Once Upon a Time speaks of falsity concealed behind smiles, absence of genuine appreciation concealed by a facade of hypocrisy, and the longing of an adult for the innocence of childhood. See, the fifth stanza of this poem, and I have learned to laugh with only my teeth. Through this line, in this poem, fifth stanza, the poet says he has also learned to change his face and learn to laugh not from my heart. Artificially, he also have learned to laugh for others, to laugh with only my teeth and shake hands without my heart. He has also learned shake hands to other people without his heart. I have also learned to say goodbye. He has also learned to say goodbye to show like his inner heart, but it is also artificial, hypocrisy. He has also learned from this world. When I mean good riddance, here good riddance means experiences of relief at being free of an unwanted person. Expressions of relief at being free of an unwanted person. That is the meaning of good riddance. To say glad to meet you without being glad. They are saying without being glad, persons are saying glad to meet you without being glad, and to say it has been nice talking to you. This is also a hypocrisy sentence uttered by people nowadays. It has been nice talking to you after being bored. Here, through this entire fifth stanza, the poet tells it, the poet has also learned to laugh with only his teeth, which means in a fake manner, without any emotion. He learned to shake hands with others without wholeheartedness. And also, I have learned to say goodbye. When I mean good riddance, here it means he has learned to say goodbye to others, wherein he actually has to say good riddance, a feeling of relief when an unwanted person leaves. And say, to say good to meet you, to say glad to meet you without being glad, and to say it has been nice talking to you after being bored. Here he says through these lines, he has even learned to say glad to meet you without being glad. Being not glad, he says glad to meet you like other people. He has also learned to say it has been nice talking to you. These words also he has learned after being bored with his talks. It is not bore to talking with you. This is also a hypocrisy, smile and words. So he has learned to keep his real character a secret. He has hidden his character as a secret one and shows the world a fake character. He shows to the world a fake character, but really he has hidden his real character in the hide. Okay, see the sixth stanza of this poem. But believe me, son, I want to be what I used to be. When I was like you, I want to unlearn all these muting things. Unlearn all these muting things. Most of all, I want to relearn how to laugh. For my laugh in the mirror shows only my teeth like a snake's bare fangs. Here he says, but believe me, son, I want to be what I used to be when I was like you. In this line, in the fifth stanza of third line, like has come. That's why it's considered as simile. He has used this like. When I was like you, I want here simile to unlearn all these muting things. Here also, he has told through this line to the readers that through his son, he wanted to say the hidden things in the world. But believe me, son, I want to be what I used to be when I was like you. I want to unlearn all these muting things. Most of all, I want to relearn how to laugh for my laugh in the mirror. Shows only my teeth like a snake's bare fangs. Here in this last line also, the poet has used like. That's why it's considered as simile. See, through this stanza, entire stanza, he says, he tells his son that when he was at his younger days, he wanted to be an honest, genuine person. He pleads his son to believe it as it is a truth. Now he wants to get rid of the things which mute or silence his real emotions and wishes to return a more natural style of living. See, here fangs, the poet has used the word fangs. Fangs here means teeth of a venomous snake used to inject poison. That is called fangs. See, most of all, I want to relearn. The poet wants to relearn through this world in the innocence, laughing and behaving. That's why he used these words. I want, most of all, I want to relearn from this world. He thinks that the reflects of his childhood through his son. That's why he has used, most of all, I want to relearn how to laugh for my laugh in the mirror. If he see the mirror at his own portrait, he can see the son of him is reflection of his young childhood days and young. Shows only my teeth like a snake's bare fang. Here, most of all, he wants to relearn how to laugh genuinely, wholeheartedly, with a good warm feel. At present, his fake artificial laugh in the mirror shows only his teeth are like a snake's poisonous teeth. He feels that he is deeply unhappy with his fake personality. Through this line he shows, he feels that he is deeply unhappy because the world is deceiving him with his fake personality. He has also learned now, like others. See the last sentence of this poem. So show me, son, how to laugh. Show me. He thinks that the reflection of his childhood and younghood is his son. That's why he asked his son, so show me, son, how to laugh. Show me how I used to laugh and smile once upon a time when I was like you. See the last line, once upon a time when I was like you. This is a repetition word. We can say he has used like word. That's why it's considered as simile. So show me, son, how to laugh. Here is last stanza. Through this stanza, the poet asks his son to show him how to laugh sincerely and genuinely. Children do not fake things. They show what they feel inside, they cannot hide their expression. That's why he says his son is innocent and small. That's why he cannot, he won't hide his feelings. Again, the phrase "once upon a time" reiterates the fact that the poet wants to be what he used to be once when he was young. Okay, we can see face is the index of the mind. Through this poem, we can describe in a nutshell. Yes, as the face clearly reflects the inner feelings of an individual, it is regarded as the index of the mind. In this poem, the poet tells his son that his fake artificial laugh in the mirror shows only his teeth. Teeth are like a snake's poisonous teeth. He confesses that his childhood innocent character has now been changed, and he feels that he is deeply unhappy with his fake personality. The poet confesses that his childhood innocent characters has now been changed, disappeared, because the world has taught him the hidden things mean artificial smile and hypocrisy. That's why he is also feeling sad, and he has also learned because the world, and he feels that he is deeply unhappy with his fake personality. The poet tells his son that in the past time, the reflection of his son in his youth, childhood days, people used to laugh with their eyes. In those days, the people are laughing through their heart. We can see the laughing and glad through their eyes. Eyes always cannot say the lie. It means that their eyes show the pleasure with him. Further, the poet says that he has learnt to act or behave to the need of the situation. For that, he tells it is to wear many faces like dresses, or faces can change through the situation. According to the situation, it can change more type. He wears several faces, depends upon the moods, such as home face, office face, street face, host face, and cocktail face. So this adage concurs with the views of the poets.